Hey there, Pittsburghers. This is Elaine Henricks, the Education and Outreach Associate with the Pittsburgh Water and Sewer Authority. You probably already know that it's really important to wash your hands often to stay healthy and prevent the spread of harmful germs. But do you know how the combined power of soap and water actually gets your hands clean? I'm going to show you with a quick hand washing experiment that you can do at home using just cooking oil, soap, and tap water. Start the experiment by rubbing a few drops of cooking oil all over your hands. First, we are going to try rinsing the oil off our hands with just water. Turn on the sink faucet and let the clean water run over your hands. Then, turn off the faucet. What happened to the oil? Yeah, the oil is still coating my hands. Why didn't the water remove the oil? Well, water is made up of small parts called molecules. Each water molecule is made up of two hydrogen atoms and one oxygen atom, which is why water is also known as H2O. Water molecules have bonds that make them stick to each other tightly. When we tried rinsing off our hands, the water molecules were attracted to each other so strongly that they formed small water drops rather than mix with the oil. The strength of the bonds between water molecules at the surface of each water droplet formed an invisible skin called surface tension, and the water droplets rolled right over our oil-coated hands. That's why rinsing your hands with just water doesn't remove oil, germs, and teeny dirt particles. You need more than water to get your hands truly clean. Let's see what happens when we try washing our hands with soap. Wet your hands with clean running water, turn off the faucet, then apply soap to your hands. Lather your hands by rubbing them together with the soap. Lather the backs of your hands, between your fingers, and under your fingernails. You need to scrub your hands for at least 20 seconds to surround and capture all the oil, germs, and dirt with soap and water. Make sure to scrub every part of your hands with soap. Don't forget to scrub around each wrist, over your thumbs, and under your fingernails. Now that you've scrubbed long enough to loosen all the oil, germs, and dirt, you need to rinse your hands under clean running water to wash it all away. Dry your hands using a clean towel and examine the results. Did the soap, water, and 20 seconds of scrubbing remove the oil? Yep, the oil is all gone and my hands are clean now. How did the combined power of soap and water get our hands clean? Soap molecules are shaped like lollipops with a wavy stick. The round end of the molecule is hydrophilic or water-loving, which means it is attracted to water molecules. The other end of the soap molecule is hydrophobic, or water-fearing, which means it repels water molecules. Each soap molecule's hydrophilic end combines with the water, while its hydrophobic end faces the other way and sticks to oil, germs, and dirt instead. The soap breaks up the surface tension that keeps water molecules stuck together and allows the water to mix with the oil, germs, and dirt. Scrubbing all over your hands with soap and water helps capture all the oil, germs, and dirt. Rinsing your hands with clean running water carries the soap, oil, germs, and dirt off your hands and down the drain.
Try out this experiment at home and remember to wash your hands often, even if they don't look dirty. Proper hand washing is easy and it's one of the most effective ways you can prevent the spread of germs among your family, friends, and entire community. Here at the Pittsburgh Water and Sewer Authority, we are committed to providing our customers with clean, safe water for drinking, cooking, and cleaning. Our water treatment processes are effective at inactivating viruses and other germs, and we continuously monitor our treatment system to make sure your tap water is of the highest quality.